This one goes out to all the Fuji fanboys or Leica fanboys or I don't know, Canon fanboys or Sony fan. I can't say fanboy. All the fanboys out there, this is for you. What's up? My name's Chris Tejas. I'm a photographer and videographer based in Ontario, Canada. I mainly shoot portraits, weddings, events, stuff like that. If there's a person in the photograph, that makes sense for me. And so that's what I tend to photograph. I shoot on Fuji, but I also shoot on Nikon, but I also shoot on Sony sometimes and Canon. And recently I've been shooting on the Lumix system and I'm moving around all the time. I think it's beneficial for me. I think I've learned a lot over this past few years of shooting on lots of different systems. And I want to talk about why I actually think it's beneficial to shift around and to not get stuck into one system. Now, there's also drawbacks, and I will talk about that. And I don't think this is for everybody, but I will talk about my scenario and why I've chosen to do it the way I have and how I would do that again with the things that I've learned from each system. You see a lot of YouTubers talking about, like, I switched to Sony or buy Sony, high Canon or whatever, right? That's not really what I'm talking about here. What I'm talking about is the idea of, like, exploring other systems before you get too deep and stuck into one, or shooting on multiple systems at once. That's something that I don't think is covered enough here on YouTube, is the idea that, like, you can have more than one camera system. You don't have to just shoot Sony or just shoot Canon or whatever. You can shoot on multiple systems. Yeah, it's more expensive. Yeah, it is a different workflow, but it might be a better workflow for you. That's something I've been contemplating a lot lately, and that's why I have been exploring systems over this past while, trying to understand what works best for me. Let's go over the benefits of exploring different camera systems and maybe shooting multiple systems. First and foremost, I think it helps you to grow as a photographer. I think learning how different systems work, learning what you like and what you don't like, is really beneficial to you as a photographer because you start to get a better understanding of what you need out of a camera. If you've only ever shot with one camera, you can get very, very good at using that camera, but there might be something missing from it that you never knew would be really beneficial to you, or there might be stuff with it that you just absolutely don't need. It might turn out that that's the perfect camera for you, or it might turn out that maybe you should be looking into another system. You wouldn't know that if you were just using one camera all the time. I kind of like, this is a hard one for me to film because, like, I really believe that hopping around all the time to different systems constantly and constantly investing money in them is not the right approach. But I do think there's positives to it, and I don't want to shy away from that idea just because I feel like it's a nuanced conversation. So I'm really gonna try and, like, thread those two things together here. But I just wanna make it really clear that I don't think that moving systems all the time is good as a professional photographer. But I do think as a new photographer, if you can get an opportunity to try lots of other systems, it can be really, really helpful. The reason it's helpful to be able to use other cameras is if you're getting a second shooting gig, or you're getting the opportunity to shoot for somebody and they want you to use their system, it can be really beneficial if you can hop onto that and not have to have this huge learning curve just to know how to use the system. The thing is, like, systems used to be more simple, right? Back in the DSLR days or the SLR days, it was just like your exposure triangle, and that's more or less what you needed to know. That's still true. Like, that is still the basics of taking a photograph. But now, like, the menu systems are so complex, there's so many different things you can do. So many ways you can, like, map buttons and all that stuff, that, like, somebody hands you a camera, it can be complicated. Like, the other day I was given a Nikon Z8 to work with for a while, and I had to spend a little bit of time just, like, trying to wrap my head around how the camera worked. I would say the first, like, 20 minutes was pretty complicated, and that's because I haven't really shot on a Nikon since the D800, which is a pretty old camera. So that meant that I had to get used to the menu system, I had to get used to the autofocusing system, all the, like, little things that now I feel like if somebody handed me that Z8 again, I would be like, cool, I know how to use this, I'm comfortable. But I wouldn't know that nearly as quickly if I hadn't used it previously. So just getting the chance to use gear will make you better at using that gear in the future, which can be helpful if you have to jump around systems based on who you're shooting with. Secondly, I think it really helps you to understand what you like. You know, if you shoot on a Canon, I don't know, 5D Mark IV, and then you jump into a Sony a7 IV, those are very, very different cameras. And you're going to see what some of the benefits are of jumping into new tech, but also into a new system and a new way of thinking about photographing. And you're going to see what works better for you. You know, just because you're comfortable with something doesn't mean it's the best option. Or just because something is uncomfortable doesn't mean it's a bad option. So trying new things, trying new cameras and that kind of stuff, if you can do it in a cost-effective way, I think it can be really beneficial to you to understand what you actually want out of a camera. The other thing I think it's great for is it helps you to understand reviews better. Like if I put out a review on this camera here, the Lumix S5 2X, but all you've ever shot with is like a Canon R6 Mark I. If that's the only camera you've ever had because you started with that camera, it's a pretty baller camera to start with considering. But if that's the only camera you've ever had, you're not going to necessarily understand the language that you need to in order to understand my review effectively. And I might be able to like point you in the direction of this camera and make you think like, oh, this is the perfect camera for me. But then you get it in your hands, you spend all the money and stuff, and you realize like, oh, I wish I knew this, or I wish I knew that, or whatever, because you may not have the experience of trying other things quite as often. And so then like reviews maybe don't hit the same way for you. Like I've used all these different systems, and so when somebody puts out a review on a Sony camera, I understand the basic structure of that camera better than I did before I shot with it. And I know right away if it's something I want to even explore or not. And so it just helps me to kind of like, you know, kind of like push away all the bullshit and just kind of get to the heart of the argument when it comes to a camera review. So I find that helpful. You know, if you're somebody who's shot on the same camera for a decade, you understand that camera incredibly well. But I have heard from people, you know, who have been photographing a lot longer than me, two things. One is that they're like, I don't give a shit about all that, which is the right way to be. Who cares about what camera reviews are saying? Like, you got to figure out what's right for you. But also like people just being like, there's way too much fucking going on. Like I haven't shot with a camera that's complicated before. And like, it's getting in the way of me taking the photos I want to take. And so maybe that's kind of the important thing there, is that like, if a new system is getting in the way of you being able to produce the images you want to produce, it's going to be a longer learning curve to get there. So if you can become more familiar with different systems, it can help you with doing that. There's some obvious drawbacks to this. The first one being it's expensive. Now for me, when I worked at a camera store, I was able to get things at good deals. I also was pretty aware of what the used market was selling things at, so I could buy and sell used gear fairly effectively and not really lose any money. Ostensibly being able to like rent camera stuff for free, because I knew if I bought this at this price, it would maintain its value for this long, and I could sell it at this price. And as long as I had a bit of a buffer, I knew that I would be able to get away with trying lots of different cameras and systems and not having to pay an arm and a leg and not make anything back. That's kind of a unique situation, but I do think more people can take advantage of that if you just spend the time and buy things at the right price. Or more importantly, just go test out gear. Like go to a camera shop and ask if you can use stuff, ask to try things out. You know, ask friends who have different systems, like, hey, can we swap systems for a day and see what that's like? I, as long as your friends are cool with you trying out their gear, then you're gonna get a lot of opportunity to learn and stress test it. The problem with like just sitting in a camera store and trying things is that you're not actually getting to put the camera through the paces. You can see what the menus are like, you can see how it feels, but until you go and shoot on it, you don't really know. Like the Z8, I shot on it for 2 days straight, photo and video, and I feel really confident that I know how that camera feels in my hands. I certainly don't know that camera super well, but I feel confident that like, I know if I would like holding that camera for 12 hours. The answer is yes, by the way. It's a really, really, really nice camera. And I love the images that came out of it. So it's so expensive. The other few negatives I would say is that it is time consuming switching to a new system. Like, you know, if you're going to like try a new camera and lens combo, you have to kind of learn how those work, and you have to spend some time, you know, maybe it's like watching reviews on like, or like watching like tutorials on how to use the camera or whatever. Like it's time consuming. It's also distracting. It gets in the way of you taking photos sometimes. And that was something I kind of touched upon earlier, but if you are, you know, constantly fiddling with menus and stuff like that, you're just not as present as a photographer or videographer as you would be if you just really, really knew your camera. That's a big downside to doing this. And that's something that you have to be very, very clear with yourself on. The last thing is that like, it's hard to master a system or a camera if you don't have it for a long time. People I know who have had like the 5D Mark III for like, since it came out and are still shooting on it, they know that camera like in the dark, right? And you're probably not gonna get to that point with a camera if you're switching systems all the time. So keep that in mind. The last thing here is that you don't necessarily need to switch systems. Maybe you just are integrating a system into what you do. I have a real love affair with like older DSLRs. I love the 5D Classic, the 5D Mark II, the Nikon D800, the Nikon D600. I love those cameras. I think they're beautiful. You know, some of the older Fujis that I love, love, love. I think what you can think about is like, what is my purpose for this camera? and what do I need it for? What am I gonna use it for? And how does it fit into my workflow? So let's say you're primarily shooting video and you have like a Sony FX30. Not an awesome camera for stills. Like you can take photos with it, but it just doesn't have a lot of the little things you might want when you're getting into a camera for stills. But if 90% of the work that you do is video related and you just want a camera to take some photos on or an extra camera to have kicking around in case you're gonna do some photography, I don't know that like going into one of the Sony cameras is necessarily gonna be right for you. You could go into one of the crop sensor, like the A6400 or something like that. And that'll keep you in the Sony ecosystem, but you could go with an older DSLR from another company and you could get like beautiful images and have a really nice, just like simple photo taking experience and probably pay less. And so in that scenario, you're adopting the idea of using multiple systems and that's okay. You're allowed to shoot on other systems. So you might have like a Canon and a Nikon and a Sony at the same time. And that's not the end of the world. It's fucking cool. Don't stress on like having to stick to one ecosystem. If your budget can allow you to do that effectively, like if you're like, my main workhorse is the FX30 and the like 11 mm 1.8 and like a 28-75 or I don't know what lenses they have, something like that. And that's what you make all your money on. And then you also have a Nikon D600 with the, you know, F1.4 50 mil because you love how that looks and how that renders images. That's okay. You're allowed to do that. Don't worry what anybody else on YouTube says. It doesn't matter. Just shoot with the stuff you like. Somebody who's a big proponent of this that I really love is Martin Kastein. He is awesome. I'll link his channel below. He does lots of stuff on older gear, which is really cool. And he talks a lot about how you can accomplish different things with different cameras and it's okay to use different systems. So I'll link him below. Hope that makes sense. Appreciate you for watching. Let me know in the comments what you're shooting on right now, other cameras you've used in the past, what you like. I'd be super curious. And like what camera do you like to use for what? So like I have certain cameras I love for portrait work, other cameras I love for landscape, other cameras I love for video. Like what, if you were to like make a list and could have all the cameras you wanted within reason, I guess, what would that look like? Appreciate you so much. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, do all that shit. Bye.